what day is it, man? I'm losing track. My body is in pain. Eh? I think I need vitamins. I was supposed to start the show with some words of wisdom, but I don't remember them. Like, someone did whisper them to me, but I think I wasn't concentrating. I didn't. Anyway, who needs wisdom? The whole world. Go to the internet, Google, you'll find a lot of wisdom. So I've been told. My name is Tina Fierce One. Welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Anyway, drama ensued. Okay, drama ensued in my mind. I was like, someone give me tea. Give me tea. This is beautiful. So, remember yesterday I was talking about King Saha and how you guys were trolling him for not speaking English, blah, blah. But there's a part I think I forgot. King Saha was like, by the way, I'm a very, very good writer. I wrote for Chameleone. I wrote for him, Valu Valu, and Badilisha. I was like, yes, yes. I think I even talked about that. Chameleone is in, what country is that? Is in the United States of these Americas. And when he had that, now, take note that King Saha was on national television with Calvin the Entertainer when he actually uttered these absurdities. Now, Chameleone comes in, sends an audio note, and also goes on his official Facebook pages, and he writes all this stuff down. He's like, yo, first of all, introduction to correction. King Saha has never written for me a single song. I have no beef with him. I respect him musically. He is a talented guy, but whatever ata niko kusiru wala no kwe wudisa. Mbuye yampandi kidenyu enyimba, like him and Calvo should stop being mad. I was like, God, Dave, that is what they call receipts. But I haven't seen receipts though. He claims he wrote them. How dumb would he be to say something like that on national television, well knowing that Chameleone is alive and well, and he is definitely going to find out. Because let's not forget, Valu Valu and Badilisha were like the only two songs in the past decade that he had done that made him lots of money. So he finna stand up and come correct on that. I was like, whoa. So he did this whole write-up. He even did an audio note. I'm like, God damn. God damn. But in the audio note, the thing that caught my attention is how we were talking music and we're talking about him writing and all of that. I don't know how to give it a bit. Why are you artists all starting to act like you're so politically inclined? For the first time, your eyes have been opened to, oh, the bad financial situation of the country. Ooh, the bad economic situation of the country. Ooh, the infrastructure is bad. Why is it now? Bobby Wine has given too many people hope. Too many people hope, which is a good thing. It's a good thing, and then again, at times, it's not such a good thing because some people are just hopelessly hoping. You know what that means? Anyway, I'm waiting for what King Saha has to say. But Saha, really? Why do you feel you have to prove yourself to Ugandans? Like, you could have just said, "Zino mpandike nyimba nyingi." Te wandye sivya kunyimba kwa katika gai kakuswaziza. To a point that now, we're going back to the whole conspiracy of, okay, Rinda, maybe those are actually radio songs like we thought. Because now we're like, wait, if he's saying he wrote something and the owner of the song comes out and say, no, blood, don't even, you didn't write it. What are the chances that what he has written now or what he's been singing is actually not his, but he's taking us for a ride? I mean, if you could lie on a person that is still alive and well, what about on a person that is dead and gone? I just like to think of these things in this way. But you see, I have no issues with Saha. I understand that he's coming down. Saha was used to people liking his music. He wasn't used to being this exposed. Like, for him, he had his songs like Wayoka Hit Kamu, you love him and leave him alone. Now, he's joined with Wizzo. He's now going to the big leagues. He's going to Koch Studio. So I think, in more ways than the other, he could be overwhelmed. Like, his celebrity is just hitting him now. At first, it was there. But now, it's hitting him and he's overwhelmed. I'm like, yo, well, son. Oof, you need to get it together. It's not a good look to be caught lying on national television like that. I mean, you're worse than Justice Smollett right now. Okay, no one can stop Justice Smollett. Like, his is beautiful. Oof. Anyway, here's the audio note. If you think, ebigambo tubiteeka mu kamwa ka Chameleone.
Kati omukulu Calvin na ye, bwaba akola emirimu gye, yeetegereze. Kati bwagwe ne bwakwa ekifo kya TV presenter. Baba kuwadde okubanga olinga nga judge oba jury asalirawo omulabi nono byayogera kiba nti abantu boogera ebintu ebitagwande ku TV ono presenter yalina okubudaabuda programu yenyumira abantu kati bwe namutulire naye ali kuli ku TV akanula amaaso nga naye agoberera ebintu ebitali mu makulu sigira abayimbi abo buli mwaina okumanya levo ye buli mwaina okumanya levo ye ofuna bulungi nnyo bwe waandika ebiyimbi ebyo ebitanyumira abantu babisuule ffe ntuwandika ennyimba ezinyumira abantu ate ne bazeeripako kyekyensi baŋŋamba abantu tetujja kukyusa ggwanga nga tukyusa ntegeera yaffe entegeera yaffe tunaagikuumira emmanju era tugenda kusigala mu manju nategeera tuteeka entegeera yaffe mu maaso kati nze Saha mutabani wange mukwano gwange muganda wange bw'ataliku okwogera ebintu ng'ebimmalamu amaanyi lwa nsonga nti ayogera ebintu ebyobulimba ng'ategeka ennyini akimanyi tikyalimbirako si kike si kike oyovaluvalu my friend ne Badilisha ezo genius mind si mu mind sika container ezo zi 40 feet omuntu oguyiye ebintu bifaanana ng'ebyo.
I think tuli team 12 would this this year. It's like everybody's losing their marbles. I don't even know why. Anywho, as we're still dealing with King Saha lying on national television and him being put back in place in line, tuchakwasaganyebyo and then Nezireta Khalifa Aganagana. Aganagana has been trying so hard to get, you know, some news time. He's been trying so hard to get prime time. He's been trying so hard to go viral, to trend and all of that. The last one he did when he was about to release that song is he went on a balcony and told us about his new Muzungu girlfriend. And we were all looking at him like, you know she ain't even yours. But anyway, he's back at it again, people. He's back at it again. Now, I bumped into a video of him talking about how he's mad, how Bebe Cool does not let, okay, like the rant was real and long, right? He's like, Bebe Cool has blocked no artist can go see the president, even if they have their brilliant ideas or they have their worries, their concerns. Bebe Cool is unblocking everything. Like, all I could hear was Bebe Cool that, Bebe Cool this, Bebe Cool that. Like, you want to meet the president, Aganaga, really? And say what? And say what? Imagine, just imagine, like this guy is busy. This guy is running a very volatile country at the moment. This guy has ish to do, and you want him to take time out for you. Now, man, this is the effect I was telling you. Ketwafuna Bobby Wine and Bebe Cool nebe joining them politics. They are giving so many artists too much ambition. Buli wenchuka ngenda kwe Zimbabwe butambala. Ngenda kwe Zimbabwe chenjojo. Ngenda kwe Zimbabwe leader. I'm like, Bambi mwesimbe. It's a good thing. It's a good thing that you're finally waking up to understanding the things you want. It's a good thing. Na yeche mutagenda kola no kusiru wala mkugatemu. Like, no, manya woko ma. Aganaga really. You want to, we all want to meet the president. All of us want to meet the president, but not all of us can meet the president. But there are certain people that honestly don't. What do you want from the president? What do you want? I mean, why don't you go through the right channels? Go through the right channels. You know what the right channels are? Well, you sit down, you write a letter, it gets to him, they will let you know or notify you if it has been approved for a scheduled visit after 90 days. Yes, that is what happens. But you do not jump the queue. You see, Aganaga bin Evin Tunjagala Anku Higiriza, now that you're at the big boys table, let me teach you what to do. Before you aim for the president, you could have first started with your local NC1 and see if you can meet him. We yongere yogende wa RDC, wa DISO, mayewe yongere yogende wa MP wechecharu. Umanyo manye kati yaone minister mufuna. Like, you have to climb these tires steadily. What does he want to tell the president? Does he want the president to, what, name a street after his shoes? And on that note, by... Before I can say anything else, at Tina Fierce One is my Twitter handle. And on Facebook, it's at ScoopOnScoop and at Tina Fierce One. Not forgetting on Instagram, at Tina Fierce One with an H. I'll catch you tomorrow on a Thursday. I am going to review an Eddie Kenzo song that I've seen. It's been a minute without me talking foul about Eddie Kenzo, but I just don't understand. Chiwanda is trying to sell the country with curvy women, for crying out loud. Eddie Kenzo, what are you selling with making our kids put on bright yellowed prisoner looking uniforms and playing and dancing in clearly stagnant, dirty water, all in the name of what? Creativity? Mwaba tunde gwanga lya febubi. Aba na eba kutena aba twala mu swamp. Ngamazo galaba gamaze emyaka kanana nga tegatambula. Damn. No wonder they're still doing commercials of African kids with canoes running here and a fly on their eye. It's people like you. They believe that's what we have here, but hey, I'll not get into that now. I'm out. Peace.